A multitasking personality who is directing the movement of vehicles on a worksite, who is recommending and laying out safe on-site traffic systems, who is providing clear, correct, and safe directions to plant operators and heavy machinery drivers. This person is communicating with drivers and plant operators verbally and by radio and are industry standard hand signals. A person who is understanding risks such as blind spots and how to manage these risks effectively and timely. A person who is managing traffic to avoid excessive queuing at the worksite. A person who is minimizing possible risks to personnel and equipment, and he or she might be working on a building or construction site. This is the question. I'm talking about whom? You have to give the answer in the comment section. Dear friends and fellows, today I'm going to discover the duties, roles and responsibilities of a rigger and a signalman. Hello and welcome. I'm Javed and you are on the platform of Safety First. But what is the first priority? Life. How to save life? How to avoid injuries at the worksite? How to protect workers from accidents? How to protect workers' families from sufferings and deprivations? If you are new on this channel, kindly subscribe Safety First Life. And if you find the video informative, then like, comment and share with your colleagues and friends. This training session is developed to provide better understanding to those who are involved in work activities like lifting operations and the lifting equipment. This presentation will help and assist the rigger and the signalman to better understand their roles and responsibilities by showing them better techniques and how to inspect the rigging gear like shackles, wire ropes, chain slings, hooks, and how to communicate and recognize the crane hand signals. Responsibility number one for rigger or a signalman. They must have a proper attire uniform and they will wear it at all times during the lifting operation. Their PPE, personal protective equipment and uniform, might include reflective vest, safety boots, gloves, identification tag, and safety helmet. Have a look in the photograph. On the right hand side, this is the photograph for rigger. And on the left hand side, this is a signalman who is carrying a radio in his right hand. Duty number two. A banksman or a rigger have to check slings and ensure that the rigging angle is correct. Duty number three, the banksman or a rigger to make sure the load is properly secured and inform the crane operator of the weight of the load. Number four, a rigger or a signalman. This is their prime duty to check lifting gears. They have to make sure the lifting gears such as slings and shackles are well maintained and in good working condition. Number five, a rigger or a signalman have to make sure the load is stable, secure and balanced before any lifting operation. The way how they will inspect, how they will check, you can easily identify by the photographs on the slides. Number six, a banksman or a rigger have to make sure any loose items are placed in a proper receptacle or container to prevent the load from falling during the lifting operation. Number seven, a banksman or a rigger have to report immediately If they find any defective or faulty lifting gear at site, to their respective lifting supervisor or the lifting appointed person. But in any case, they will not use faulty or defective lifting gear that might cause a lifting accident. Number 8, a rigger or a slinger has to place adequate paddings on the edges of the load to prevent the sling from damage. Number 9, a rigger or a slinger must know the correct use of choker hitches on the right hand side. At the top, you can see how a choker hitch might be, but in any case, they have to make sure there is no cutting action on the running lines. Don't use the shackle pin as it will become loose over time. Make sure there is no cutting action of the wire rope, sling eye on the running line. If there is a defect, they will not use it. Number 10, it is also the responsibility of a rigger or a banksman to use the shackle in a correct way to balance the shackle load. If it is required, they have to insert sufficient washer to centralize the position of the shackle. But at the other end, they will make sure the shackle is not pulled down at an angle. Have a look in the photograph. Upside, this is the correct way of using the lifting gear. But down below, on left side, it is unsafe. It should not be used in this way. Number 11, a rigger or a banksman must know the correct hookup method. They will make sure the safety latch is in good condition, and they will also make sure the shackle is hooked up correctly and is equally spaced apart. Responsibility number 12, a rigger or a banksman must be able to know the correct rigging method. They will secure the hooks with the load facing outside, but never secure the hooks facing in, or never wrap a rope around the hook, keeping the hook facing inside, or wrapping a rope around the hook. Both are the substandard practices. It is not allowed in any case during the lifting operation. Responsibility number 13, rigger or a banksman have to make sure the load is rigged correctly before lifting. If the load is tilting on one side during lifting, it means it is not rigged correctly. And remember, don't tie the sling from one eye bolt to another, as it will tilt to one side. And this is not acceptable. This is a substandard lifting practice. Responsibility number 15, rigger or a banksman have to hook up unused slings. Have a look in the photograph. They will make sure any unused slings are hooked up properly, but never leave unused slings unhooked. Number 16, a rigger or a banksman must know the correct loading method. Remember, the eye bolt will bend if loading is not done correctly. Number 17, it is also the responsibility of a rigger or a banksman to use paddings during lifting. Padding is required to prevent damage to the sling. The sling will be damaged if padding are not used on the load. Number 18, do you know the method of joining sling eyes? Use a shackle to join the sling eyes, but in any case, don't use nuts, bolts, and the pieces of steel to connect the sling eyes. It is not safe. It is not acceptable. Dear friends and fellows, you are on the platform of Safety First Life. Today we are discussing about the roles and responsibilities of a rigger or a banksman. Responsibility number 19, duty number 19, a rigger or a banksman has to use the original screw pin for the shackle. Don't use a bolt as a screw pin as it will bend, and it may lead to a potential load falling accident. Number 20, a rigger or a banksman have to use the tagline to control the movement of the load to make the lifting safe. Otherwise, the jerking or shaking load might hit any of the adjacent structure or the individuals. Number 21, it is the duty of a rigger or a banksman to place load on shoring planks during unloading. Remember, don't use the crane to pull out the sling from under the load. Number 22, prior to make any lifting operation, it is the duty of a rigger or a banksman to check hook for any defect and make sure it is in good working condition. What they have to check? They have to check that hook is not twisted. They have to check for wear and cracks, signs of opening up, check for deformation, and checks for crack and twisting of the hook. A rigger or a banksman has to make sure the shackles in use are free from defects and in good working condition. What they will check in the shackle? They have to check the wear. They have to check the pins. They have to check opening width, and they have to check for cracks and twisting. Number 24, in the case of using wire ropes, they will make sure that a defective or damaged wire rope is not in use, like if it is crushed severely or if it is flattened severely. In both cases, it should not be used because it is not safe for use. In the case of wire ropes, a rigger or a banksman has to make sure that it is safe and in good working condition. Bird caging, dog leg kink, open kink, a closed kink, in all conditions, it is not allowed. For wire ropes, they will also make sure the wear and tear. If the wire rope is bulged severely, core protrusion, and excessive clearance between strands, it should not be used because this wire rope is not safe for use. It may lead to a potential lifting accident. Dear friends and fellows, the responsibility of a rigger or a banksman is to check the load is properly rigged before giving a clear signal to the crane operator to lift the load. It is also the responsibility of a rigger or a banksman to give the correct crane hand signals clearly to the crane operator to lift the load safely. Have a look. These are the few examples of recommended crane hand signals. On the left hand side, the signal for derricking jib, jib up and jib down. You can see the signals with one hand, other hand is on head. On the left side, down below, this is the signal with both hands. This is for crane. On the left side, travels to me, and on the right side, travel from me. Have a look on the right hand side of this slide for hoisting and lowering the load. How the signals are: clench and unclench fingers to signal take the strain, and down below, arm extended, pointing with finger in direction of swing of boom, slew right or slew left. Duty number 30, a rigger or a banksman, it is their prime responsibility to maintain good communication at all times. They must know the recommended hand signals. On the left hand side, you can see extended jib signal, trolley out, retract jib, trolley in. Down below, this is for stop, and at the right side, this is emergency stop. Remember, communication between lifting supervisor, crane operator, rigger, and the signalman must be maintained at all times. And they have to practice good communication within the lifting team. Dear friends and colleagues, in construction, a rigger or a banksman is an expert in tying up, balancing, manipulating and moving heavy loads. A given rigging job in the construction industry may require completely different expertise and training than another does. Let's summarize training presentation, the roles and responsibilities of a banksman or a slinger. I will clarify one thing, banksman and slinger. Banksman is usually communicating, giving hand signals or using mashola, and slinger who is attaching the load through lifting gear with the lifting equipment like crane. In different organizations, somewhere they say banksman, somewhere slinger, and most of the time the organization means banksman or a slinger have the same nature of duties. A slinger or a banksman has to check the slings, lifting gear, they have to check the load, they have to ensure lifted load is balanced and secure. A rigger or a banksman has to ensure loose loads are secured. They will report any damaged lifting gear to lifting supervisor immediately. They will use paddings on the load edges. They will correctly use the choker hitches. They will implement the correct way to balance a shaker load. They will utilize correct hooking up methods, correct rigging methods, and a banksman or a rigger will use tag lines to control the movement of the load. A banksman or a slinger has to use correct methods of unloading. He or she has to make sure that all lifting gears are of correct rating as per the load calculations and without any defect. A rigger or a banksman must know how to give correct hand signals. A rigger or a banksman has to practice good and workable communication method and maintain it throughout the lifting operation. Dear friends and colleagues, the rigger must know how to attach cables or ropes to the load. That includes knowing the right hitches to tie and the load they are support safely. Riggers can recognize any hazards associated with the lifting or moving job. A rigger can figure out where the center of the gravity has to be on a load to keep everything stable. They can signal to communicate their meaning to other members of the lifting team, like lifting supervisor or crane operator. Riggers must be able to use different types of rigging equipment, such as slings, shackles, chokers or winches. A rigger or a banksman can move heavy equipment through confined spaces safely. A rigger can tilt, dip or turn suspended loads to avoid obstacles or hazards such as overhead power line. Riggers dismantle, clean and store rigging equipment after use. A rigger must comply with all regulations and safety requirements. Do you know the requirements for a banksman or a rigger? He or she must be at least 18 years of age, be medically fit for the purpose with particular emphasis on eyesight, hearing and reflexes, have an aptitude for judging distance, height and clearance, be agile and strong enough to handle lifting gear, be trained in the general techniques of slinging or rigging, be capable of selecting lifting gear suitable for the loads to be lifted and to identify defects. Banksmen or a rigger have a sensible knowledge of the safe working loads at the various radius of the crane. Be capable of directing the safe movement of the crane and its load to maintain the safety of all personnel. And remember, a banksman or a rigger be thoroughly trained in a hand signaling system. Be capable, where necessary, of giving clear and distinct instructions over radio or a similar signaling system. He must be aware of the crane's tail radius at ground level and the possibility of being trapped between the crane and any adjacent obstruction. and don't deliberately swing loads to try and increase the radius of load deposit or pickup. When assessing the weight of loads for lifting, remember the weight of the lifting gear must be added. A rigger or a banksman has to make sure that the lifting gear used is appropriate to the situation. When guiding a mobile or crawler cranes from one location to another, watch out for backfill trenches which may settle under the crane load and cause it to topple over. Large obstruction on the ground, overhead obstruction. A rigger or a banksman have to make sure that no obstruction exists when slewing the crane, particularly electric cables of all types. If at any time in the work cycle you cannot see the driver or operator, call for assistance unless radio communication is used. Dear friends and colleagues, slinging loads on building sites using cranes can be very dangerous and sometimes disastrous unless it is carried out by a properly trained riggers. You have to consider these points when using a lifting gear. Number one, correct sling must be used for the load to be lifted. Number two, slings and chains must be padded when passing over sharp edges. Number three, shackles must have the correct pin fitted. Number four, pull the shackle must always be from ring to eye and not from side to side. And number five, hook points must always be outwards when using multiple leg sling. And remember, never lift with the point of a hook. Never use nuts and bolts to join a broken chain. Never use a chain in which links are locked or stretched. Never use corroded, worn, or excessively pitted chains. Never drag a sling from under a load. Never cross, twist, kink, or knot slings. Never join slings by treading the ice. Never drop any item of lifting gear from a height. And never exceed the safe working load marked on the lifting equipment being used. Dear friends and colleagues, if you will remember and apply these points at your work site, you can make every lift a safe lift. And that's all for now. Training session related to the roles and responsibilities of rigger and banksman is over. If you have any questions, please ask in the comment section. Thanks for watching. And don't forget to like, comment, and share the video with your friends and colleagues. Hope to see you soon with a new HSC tutorial. Till then, take care. Good luck and Allah Hafiz.